guesses what topic is going to be today's video is about? Yes, you guessed that right, if you did. And if not, I can't do anything. So, today's video is going to be about skin. Especially the skin of your face. And this video is going to contain mainly four parts. Number one, how many types of skin are there? Number two, how to find out what type of skin do you have? Number three, what problems can you face with your type of skin? Number four, what are the remedies you can try to solve your problems? And just without wasting any further time, let's just jump into the video. So let me be very clear, starting the first part of the video, there are mainly four types of skin. First is oily, second is dry, third is combination, and fourth is sensitive. Oily and dry are the most common types of skin in tropical areas, whereas people also have sensitive skin. But combination skin is not very common, I can say. But yeah, if you have common skin, combination skin, sorry. If you want, you can repeat after me. Oily, dry, combination, and sensitive. Now, I know the first part was very small, but there is nothing more to tell you about of types of skins, because this video is not just going to be deeper in types of diseases in skins and infections and allergies and all that. So just moving to the second part of the video, how can you find out what kind or type of skin do you have? So I can tell you some of the characteristics or symptoms. You just have to note out the points which matches your condition, and then you will eventually know what type of skin do you have. So going with the first type of skin, oily skin, people usually have greasy skin, pimples, acne, and bumpy textured skin. And dry skin, people have flaky skin, roughness, micro textured, and discoloration types of symptoms. Whereas the people who have combination type of skin has mixed characteristics or symptoms, you can see from dry and oily skin type, which are like acne and greasiness on T-zone of the area, and dryness on rest of the face, especially cheeks and around mouth area. Okay, now, okay, so the characteristics of sensitive skin is they are prone to acne, pimple, the skin is usually red, and they are also really, really prone to fungal infections. Now, moving to the third part of the video, which is what kind of problem you can face with your type of skin, and what are the reasons of the problems you face with your type of skin. Now, moving on with the first type of skin, which is obviously oily skin. Oily skin people tend to sweat a lot, and their face are greasy like 80-90% of the time, because the sebaceous gland present in our skin secretes sebum, which is actually really important and healthy for our skin. But people with oily type of skin tend to secrete excessive amount of sebum on their face, due to which sebum is a kind of oil which our skin secretes by its own for locking moisturizer and keeping our skin hydrated. But again, like I have said earlier, that people with oily skin type tend to secrete sebum excessively, which ends up making their face greasy and clogging their pores. And with the clogged pores and dirt from the atmosphere, they tend to have acne, fungal infections, and all those things. Now, moving on to the second skin type, which is dry skin, the case is exact opposite. The secretion of sebum by sebaceous gland is like inadequate in the skin of people having dry skin, and due to which their skin remains or tends to be dry and flaky. But there can be many more factors which can to make your skin dry, that are atmospherical changes and cold weather and pollution, etc. Now going with the third skin type, which is combination skin. As earlier, the problems and reasons of the problems are mixed of oily and dry skin type. The T-zone area, which is the forehead, nose and lip area, tend to secrete more sebum by the sebaceous gland, and T-zone only tends to be greasy and have acne and pimples, whereas the rest of the face have the problem of people having with dry skin, that the sebaceous gland secretes sebum in inadequate proportion, which again leads their skin to be flaky, dry and micro textured. Now going to the fourth and the last skin type, which is sensitive skin. So the reasons of having a sensitive skin can be a lot. Factors can differ from person to person, but mainly the reasons are their skin is really sensitive. They tend to react more with fragrances, chemicals, dyes present in products we use for face, cosmetics, skincare and all that. Now moving on to the fourth and the last part of the video, which is cure remedies and what kind of precautions you can take for your skin type. So oily skin people should wash their face with a lukewarm water and use soaps or face wash, whatever you like, with which do not contain fragrances and are not really harsh. Okay, and wash your face 4 or 5 or maybe 6 times a day. And your skin needs vitamin B2, vitamin C and E if you want healthier skin. And the must point to be considered is drink a lot of water. And the food you should avoid is dairy products. Yes, it will sound a little inappropriate, but people with oily skin should not consume a lot of milk. Instead of that, you can consume soy milk or almond milk. You should drink more lemon water, and you can use cucumber as your toner. Remedies or cures for dry skin type. Dry skin type people should use pure coconut oil for their face, like for massaging for 10 to 5 minutes before they go to sleep, and do not leave that all on your face. Okay, massage your face with pure coconut oil for 5 to 10 minutes, then wash your face and go to sleep. You will definitely see changes with good changes, not bad. Drinking a lot of water for dry skin people is also very necessary. They can also use honey to put on their face, and to same goes with aloe vera. The dry skin people needs vitamin D and E again. What food you should avoid is coffee and tea. Yes, again it will sound a little inappropriate, but dry skin people, please avoid a little coffee and tea. Now going to the third and second last skin, that is combination skin. Washing their face, they should use gentle and oil balancing face washes and exfoliate with caution, and use non-drying masks on T-zone area, and they can use masks with contains on the rest of the face. Okay, they should eat green vegetables, blueberries, guava and kiwi. You should eat food with lot of protein, and the vitamin you need is vitamin C. What to avoid is pro-inflammatory food and soy, and food which contains phytoestrogen. They should avoid meat which contains high quantity of sodium. Now going with the last skin type, that is sensitive skin type. They should take short showers from 5 to 10 minutes with the lukewarm water. They should use a gentle and again fragrance free soap. They should avoid is hard estrogens and exfoliants. What they should take for this supplement is organic and clean supplement. All these four parts I am going to end this video. Hope this video helps, and comment down if you want me to show what type of makeup does suit to what different types of skin. Bye.